Hey, we're Bondax.
You're watching the AU review at Listen Out.
You're not long off the plane. How are you feeling?
I'm pretty hyped. I think it should be fun. I mean, it's our first time ever in Australia, first Australian show. A lot of first times, so it'll be cool to see what the crowd's like. Yeah, I'm pretty excited.
It'll be a pretty quick set compared to perhaps what you normally do. Are you going to try and squeeze as much in as possible?
I mean, we're actually doing a live set, so it's not too dissimilar from our normal length. But we've taken a couple of tunes out, and we're just hoping that everyone will know the music here, because we don't know what to expect. That's the thing, you know, this is completely new to us, and so it's exciting. But I mean, I'd say it's a bit scary, but actually everyone's been so lovely to us so far. I'm kind of just ready to do this, you know.
Ready to get it over and done with.
Yeah. Ready to party later, for sure.
There you go. That's what you're really here for, isn't it? How do you make a Bondax live show?
So the live show is like me and George playing a lot of stuff. So I'm on guitar and bass, and George is on keys and vocoder. And then we have like a xylophone that we play, like a MIDI xylophone that we both play. And then we have two live singers and a drummer. And yeah, I don't know, it's quite soulful. It's quite groovy, quite funky.
Yeah.
That's how I describe it.
A MIDI xylophone.
Yeah, MIDI xylophone, man, it's sick. You can do like whatever on it, trigger whatever.
It's a bit easier, I suppose, than an actual xylophone to carry around.
Yeah, definitely. It's still...
Well, not really.
It's still quite a bane to travel with, for sure. Flying it here is not cheap, that's for sure.
There you go. Well, then flying to Australia isn't just cheap full stop.
Yeah,
is
yeah,
it?
No.
Hence why
very
this is
cheap,
your first trip
cheap.
Here.
Yeah, exactly.
You mentioned you played KL over the weekend or whatever. I don't even know what day of the week it is.
Yeah.
So I guess during the week you played KL.
Yeah.
What was that like?
Yeah, we played it when a couple of days ago now.
Wednesday night.
We had a mad time there, man. I mean, we didn't really know what to expect there as well. It was kind of a new experience. We went out to the jungle and we kind of took it all in. I just think it's amazing, like, the fact the city sort of runs straight into the wilderness, essentially. It was a mad time.
Yeah.
Very English there, though. So
yeah.
We fit in quite easily, which is kind of a good thing and a bad thing, I guess.
Yeah. Everyone speaks English. English plug sockets. All good. Easy for us.
And the food is
amazing.
Yeah.
So nice. We had some amazing food out there. And this whole, like, we did like 2 weeks in Asia pretty much. Ate a lot of nice food. A lot of nice food.
Where else did you get to in Asia?
We did Seoul, Kuala Lumpur, and Singapore. Yeah.
Singapore, another English
city. Singapore, another English city. Yeah. For sure.
So I guess that's one way to prep yourself up for Listen Out.
Yeah, no, definitely. It was cool because it's like we did 2 weeks of DJing and then we're doing this live thing for like 2 weeks and then do a week of DJing in America and then home. So it's quite a good...
So it's just DJing around Asia?
Yeah, Asia's just DJing, yeah.
So it's been... When was the last time you did a live set?
We did them throughout the whole summer festival season in England. So this is kind of... It's not been too long for us. I think the last one was Reading.
Yeah, like a month ago.
Mid-August.
Yeah. So it's
end of August.
Yeah. Following off the back of our festival run in the UK. But I tell you what, the weather is far better.
Yeah, weather's pretty nice.
The vibe's amazing here. So
yeah,
you know, let's hope it goes down well.
So tell us a little bit about your latest material. All I See. What, you know? What? Tell us about your latest jams.
So yeah, our latest single's All I See. We made it quite a while ago in a studio in London with some of our friends we wrote with. And yeah, I don't know, it's quite a tropical summery tune, like a lot of our tunes. Yeah, it's pretty happy. Yeah,
it's kind of made for this sort of weather, really.
Yeah, for
so,
sure.
So hopefully it'll translate quite well.
Yeah.
On the stage here. I mean, we don't get this every day in England, so we kind of make our music as like an ideal scenario.
Ooh. Yeah.
So it's quite nice to actually play it out in a real scenario that's like our ideal. So, yeah, I mean, we'll hopefully the music translates well here.
Yeah.
We kind of always thought our music would work in Australia, but we've never had the chance to play it here. So, like I say, we're very excited.
Yeah.
And so hopefully this is just the first time. First time of many that we see you down here.
Yeah, we'd love to come out here a lot more, for sure.
We have a lot of friends out here, actually. A lot of English are coming over because your economy is so great. There's so much going on here. So.
Although maybe it's just the weather.
And the weather. For sure.
Tell us what you've got coming up for the rest of the year.
So we got our like a compilation album coming out at the end of next month, which is like got exclusive new material from us and our friends, and you know, loads of just music we love from like our friends and stuff. And then not much really. I mean, we're doing like a tour in England till the end of the year, and then just finishing our album is the next thing, and that's going to be out next year, and then we'll be back here next year.
Fantastic.
That's the plan.
And have you had a chance to look at the lineup? Do you know who's on Listen Out? Is there anyone you're looking forward to seeing?
Yeah, I mean,
a lot of people.
We love most of the lineup here. So
yeah.
I think our priority would probably be Schoolboy Q, just because.
Yeah, he never plays in England.
And, you know, we love his music. Yeah. So that should be. Should
yeah,
be
that'd
incredible.
Be sick.
But then, I mean, like.
I want to see Taku, because he never really plays that much in England either.
Taku, Teed,
Shlomo,
I mean, all these
Flume,
guys,
Shet Faker. A lot of people. Snake Kips, obviously, they're like our good friends from England, so loads of people.
So it should be a good couple of weeks.
Yeah, it's nice to be all touring together.
Do you get to spend time here today, or do you go to Perth pretty much straight away?
We go to Perth
tomorrow really early. But we're going
to
party, and then we come back to Sydney next week, because we're doing a sideshow and stuff. So.
You go show at Oxford Art Factory.
Yeah, exactly.
Wednesday or Thursday?
Yeah, one of them days.
Thursday.
Yeah, I think Thursday. I don't know.
But I'm not sure.
Google it.
Don't turn up on this first.
Yeah.
Well, guys, wish you the best. Enjoy Australia. And
Thank you.
Hopefully your flights home are a bit easier than your flights here.
Well,
yeah, we hope
that
so.
Too. Cheers, man.